Greetings. Welcome back. Today we're going to cover two reactions. The first is a way to make really any more substituted amine, so we can use this to make secondary and tertiary amines. And the second is a way to make quaternary amines. The first of these methods is called reductive amination. Hopefully you can deduce from the name of this that we will be adding an amine onto something and then reducing it. The way that this reaction starts off is with any nitrogen-containing compound, usually an amine, and then we add some type of carbonyl to it. This could be a ketone or an aldehyde or formaldehyde, whatever is attached to that. This will give us the C double bond N, which at that point would then only have one bond remaining. And then what we can do is reduce it. The general term for reduction is a bracket with an H. It just means reduction. In general, oxidation is written as an O with brackets. So this is kind of the opposite of it. This would be reduction. And that would allow us to turn this into a CH attached to an NH. Whatever else was on there is still on there. So notice that's what happened overall, is that we've taken a nitrogen with one or two or three substituents, we've added it to this carbonyl, which gives us then the carbon from the carbonyl attached to the nitrogen that was in the amine, and our new bond is right there. Whatever the substitution on this nitrogen was at the beginning, it turns into kind of one higher, so plus one carbon. In doing this, a primary amine would go into a secondary amine. A secondary amine could be converted into a tertiary amine, or really whatever you want to do. So let's look at some examples of this. We'll shrink this down and leave it all up at the top. All right, so let's start off with hydroxylamine, which is a little easier to work with than ammonia. H2OH. If we add this guy to any carbonyl, I'm going to use a specific one in this case, but it really doesn't matter. Use this little aldehyde right here. We would be able to add that on. The C double bond O would turn into a C double bond N. In this case, the nitrogen would have the OH still attached to it. But that doesn't matter. We could then reduce it. Generally, the way to do this is with LAH, in a first step, followed by any type of water. A little bit acidic is fine. Water neutral is just fine as well, which would reduce that down and turn it into NH2. So this would go from essentially an unsubstituted nitrogen to a primary amine. All right. So let's look at what happens with a primary amine. We will start with NH2, and I will put an ethyl group on it, for instance. And we can put this in, let's add a ketone this time. The first step, we would turn that C double bond O into a C double bond N. The rest of my ketone would remain, and the ethyl group attached to the nitrogen would remain. In the second step, I would reduce it with LAH, followed by some water. These reductions can be done either using the Clemmensen reduction, which is where you add some metal and acid. They can also be done with catalytic hydrogenation, which is where you add hydrogen and platinum. Anyway is fine. LAH is much easier to use than any of those, because you don't have to be shaking things under high pressure or anything like that. We tend to deal with gases as little as possible. All right, and that would reduce it. And notice that in this case, we went from a primary amine into a secondary amine. So once again, we've added on one carbon to our chain, making it kind of one more substituted. All right, lastly, what we could do is we could start off with a secondary carbon. And let's use formaldehyde in this case. All right, and that would give us, this is a little bit odd because that nitrogen still has two carbon groups attached. So you might notice that the product of this would actually give you a quaternary amine. It's not really a quaternary amine because it doesn't have four single bonds, but it's a nitrogen with four bonds, so it's positively charged. In this case, that bond right there, the one with the C double bond N, is extremely easy to reduce because that nitrogen has a plus charge. It's essentially dying to pull these electrons to itself. So we use a really weak oxidizing agent. We don't even need to put in water afterwards because hopefully you can see the H minus would just attack bottom down here and kick that up and you'd be done. So in this case, we usually add a very weak H plus, or sorry, a weak hydride, a weak H minus. The sodium cyanoborohydride is the one that's commonly used for this. It looks like this, NaBH3CN. There's a couple other ones that get used. You might remember the lithium aluminum tritert butoxyhydride. Any of those are totally fine. Any hydride at all will work for this. We just usually use a weak one instead because we don't need to use anything strong. And then the result of this would be that guy. And notice that we started off with a secondary amine and we turned it into a tertiary amine. So this is actually the preferred method for making any secondary or tertiary amines, is starting off with a primary and turning it into a secondary, or starting off with a secondary and turning it into a tertiary. Of course, you could couple these all end-to-end if you wanted to. You could start off with a primary amine, or sorry, an unsubstituted amine, make a primary. You could take that guy down here, turn it into secondary, and then you can bring that guy down here and turn it into tertiary if you want to. So really, this is a very versatile reaction, reductive amination. And it's the only reaction we're really going to go into that lets you make a highly substituted, that is to say, a secondary or a tertiary amine. Our second and final reaction of the day involves the formation of a quaternary amine. Normally, the way that we form quaternary amines, which has to do more often than in medications or drugs, is that you can start off with any amine, whether it's primary, secondary, or tertiary, doesn't really matter. And if you put it into some acid, it would form a nitrogen that has four bonds. And this is very easy to do, as nitrogens are quite basic. But this would be a reversible quaternary amine because it would have at least but one bond to hydrogen. So that's a reaction that would make a quaternary amine, but that's not what we're going to look at in this specific reaction. All right, in this specific reaction, we're going to start with an amine, and now we'll start with cyclohexylamine. So this guy, the IUPAC name would be cyclohexanamine, and we're going to put it into an excess of methyl iodide with some sodium bicarbonate. First step, that nitrogen, which would act like a nucleophile, will attack the carbon electrophile, kick off the iodine. That would give me my cyclohexanamine, but now it would be attached to a methyl group as well. Since it would now have four bonds, it would be positively charged, but because we have that base hanging around, the sodium bicarbonate, that would grab our hydrogen and we would convert our amine back into a neutral amine, and in this case it would have, it would be a secondary amine with one hydrogen and one methyl group. We could do this over and over again. This guy right here, the nitrogen, which is neutral, has lone pairs, could attack another methyl iodide, etc., etc., and then get deprotonated and then attack another methyl iodide. And after all of that stuff, what we would end up doing is turning that nitrogen into a trimethyl nitrogen, or a quaternary amine, which had its original cyclohexyl group, but now it will have three methyl groups in addition to that. So that's a permanent quat, or a nitrogen that has four carbons attached to it. This is all well and good if that's what you're after, but in general this reaction has another step following. The nitrogen with the plus charge, right here, would like to become neutral, and the only way for that to happen is for it to pull electrons back towards itself. Since it doesn't have any hydrogens attached, the only way it could do that would be to act like a leaving group. It acts like a leaving group, generally by leaving the biggest thing over here. And so what happens in this case is we can put in a base, and the base would just do elimination. So let me draw a neighboring hydrogen. Base is going to grab that neighboring hydrogen. The electrons form a double bond and kick off the leaving group. This is an E2 elimination mechanism. And so the product of our reaction would be that that methyl group, the quaternary amine, would fall off as a leaving group, and it would give us an alkene. This is such a bulky leaving group right here, all of this bulk around here, that you really rarely ever get any type of substitution. And in fact, because that leaving group is so bulky, no matter the size of your base, you'll always pull off the most accessible hydrogen, which is something that we called Hoffman elimination before, or the Hoffman product. Well, this reaction right here is named after a Hoffman. So this is the Hoffman elimination reaction. And what it does is it starts off with an amine and converts that amine into an alkene. This is the first and only reaction that we have talked about this chapter in which you turn an amine into any other functional group. All of the other reactions, if you go back, have looked at turning amines into more substituted amines. But in this case, we're turning an amine into, momentarily, a quaternary amine, so kind of the same thing, and then we've done elimination of it. I should let you know that the base that's most commonly used in this reaction, let's try that again. The base that's most commonly used in this reaction is silver oxide, Ag2O. Silver oxide will react with water and an I minus. And then notice that we have to have formed an I minus while we were making our N plus. Right? It was left over from our methyl iodide up here. So those guys will react in the presence of water and create in the pot a little bit of hydroxide, which would be used. You could just use hydroxide. Instead, if you wanted to write down any base, I would be totally fine with it. But I just want you to notice that in the original Hoffman elimination, silver oxide was used. And so that's often what you'll see as kind of the second step for this. So the first step would be to add these reagents right here. The second step would be to add the base, particularly silver oxide. But again, if you're writing out the reagents, any base would be totally fine with me. All right, thank you very much. So today we looked at two reactions, the reductive amination, which lets us turn any amine into a slightly more substituted amine, and also the Hoffman elimination, which lets us turn an amine into a quaternary amine, so the extreme amine, and then have it act like a leaving group to form an alkene. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in class.